showbags and state of Indian books, because that's what it's all about. Now each showbag will contain a copy of William Kelly's book, Vietnam, Australia and Me, tour copies by Susan Mitchell, A Fortunate Life by Bert Facey, The Unknown Industrial Prisoner, a novel by David Ireland, and a beautiful, huge colour coffee table book called Treasures of Australia by Robin Smith, who took the photographs, and text by Cedric Clunch, which is a magnificent book. All of those will be included in each show bag. And so we'll be taking your calls after this break. So ring us now at 329-7522 and 008-333-012. We'll take some calls after this break.
Because Easter is just around the corner.
Studio outside the Angus and Robertson bookstores. And right now we're going to talk about a kind of yoga, Sahaja yoga, I hope I pronounced that correctly. And we're going to talk to a lady called Sri Mataji. And I hope I got that right too. Sahaja yoga is now a recognised religion and it's catching on at a great rate here in Australia. In fact, the religion has just been granted permission to open a school here in Victoria, and that school is situated at Kew. It's been established to comply with the extremely high moral and educational standards set by Sri Mataji. And the basic objective of the school is to instill non-aggression, peace and harmony. Yeah, yeah, would we all agree with that? Sri Mataji is in Australia for a whistle-stop tour, and she's agreed to visit us here in the mobile studio. And we'll have to put those headphones on because I forgot it's got the microphone attached to it. So if you don't put those on, we won't be able to hear you. So if you just hold that up there and speak into it. I think we'll be able to hear you okay. Welcome to Australia, first of all.
Thank you very much.
Actually, you've just stepped off the plane, I believe. Are you suffering from jet lag?
No, I don't mind.
How do you avoid things like jet lag?
I think if you are at a state where you can witness everything, you don't suffer from that.
How do you mean? What do you mean by that? Because everybody loves our children know how to get over jet lag.
It is a state of your being, when you just become the spirit. When you become the spirit, then you start seeing everything like a witness, like a drama. And you are not involved in it. When you are involved in it, then you get it. We can say that you enter into a realm where the effect and the cause do not exist.
So you become sort of separate from
yes.
Your body, if you like.
No, no. You are beyond it. You are in the body itself. But in the body only you achieve a state where you see everything as if you are witnessing a drop.
Right. And then how do you overcome, because I know that many branches of yoga, of course, are very much involved with the body and the mind and how the mind can control the body, which I find fascinating.
Here you don't have to control anything. You have a force within you called Kundalini, which is situated in the bone called sacrum, which is sprouted spontaneously as a living process, as the epitome of your evolutionary process and you become the spirit. So there's nothing to be achieved in it, you just become. Becoming is the point.
Many branches of yoga I know are involved in trying to raise this energy, if you like, called the Kundalini, and it's done through meditation in lots of areas. Is that how you do it? Through meditation?
No meditation, nothing. You see, it is a spontaneous thing. I would say that to sprout a seed, you don't meditate. It sprouts by itself.
How do you do it then?
It is a living process. Like the Mother Earth has the power to sprout a seed. In the same way, supposing somebody is enlightened, he can sprout your Kundalini. And once you are sprouted, you can also help others. So simple as that.
So could you raise this energy in me, for example?
Of course, why not? I did for many interviewers who came to me.
Well, how would you do it?
Just talking to me, you might get it.
Just by being here?
Yes.
What will it feel like if I get it?
You will feel the cool breeze coming out of your hands. You feel the cool breeze coming out of your fontanel bone area on top of your head. It's an actualization of baptism. Actualization, not artificial, like somebody puts the hands and baptizes you. But actually, you feel the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost coming out of your head.
Well, I don't feel that at the moment.
You will, very soon.
All right, now I'm holding your hand. So, well, I'll just wait and see if it happens. What's the advantage of this? I mean, you say that you can use it to help other people. How can you do that?
You see, because this is the force which connects you to the all-pervading power of God. And this power does all that is vital, all that is important, all that is living. So once you get to that power, when you are connected with it, you can maneuver that power and use it to help others who are sick because this power is a little bit exhausted in them or some other problems are there. All of them can be cured if you can just use this power, know how to maneuver it and give it to them. And once they get connected, they are permanently all right.
You said before that you mentioned the Holy Spirit. Now, that's really a sort of Christian term, isn't it?
Yes.
And you really espouse all kinds of religion, don't you? Not just yoga.
Yes, but Christians are like that. You see, they want to apportion everything to themselves. Christ was not born for only Christians, and not Holy Ghost is only for Christians. Holy Ghost is a very, very old understanding in India. It is called as Adi Shakti. And the representation of Holy Ghost is in the triangular bowl, which is the Kundalini. But Christ was not allowed to speak much. He had only 4 years and they crucified him. So you can imagine what must have been the state. How can you in 4 years do something? I mean, it took me years to put these things into the heads of people.
So you think that, would you agree that then there is not only one way to achieve union with God or knowledge about God, that there are all different kinds of ways?
No, only one way, because there's only one way you can sprout the seed by the Kundalini, in the same way there's only one thing which is lying as the Kundalini. I don't know of any other force that lies more than that. That's the one kept there for this purpose only.
Well, does that mean then that somebody can only have this power through somebody like you, or can they do it by themselves?
By themselves you cannot, because a light which is enlightened can enlighten another candle, but by itself the candle cannot get.
So in other words, you have to have a guru.
But a good guru who knows the job, the one who takes you to God and not takes your money.
Yeah, I was just going to say that. There's a lot of gurus around who drive around.
That's all a marketing thing. It's an enterprise.
So how do you find the right guru, the one who won't take your money? You don't take any. You never take any money, do you?
No. You see, how can you pay? What do you pay? I mean, I just don't understand. How much do we pay for our being? In the same way, what can we pay about? But to find the guru is nowadays very difficult, because I know there are some good ones, they don't want to come out of their hiding places. But best is you become the guru as soon as you get your Kundalini awakened in Sahaja Yoga. You become your own guru, you don't need anyone. Because you become the spirit and the spirit is your guide.
Let's talk about your schools for a moment. And as I mentioned here in the introduction, you're going to start up a school here in Victoria. How do they differ from conventional schools?
Very much different, you see, because first of all, we see that the children become the spirit. They are born also sometimes as realized children. They are very sensitive to evil and good. And they are very different type of very high moral children. And they can't bear something like this. But they are forced because of our modern times, forced them into things which they don't like. All such children can be admitted in a school like this by being there as realized souls. Gradually, they understand that they are very much appreciated and wanted. Not only that, but they take very easily to moral sense. You don't have to tell them. They become morally ill. They become morally ill. They know what is right and what is wrong. And they are not forced into it, again I say. And the education also, they become very dynamic. They learn things very well. They get very disciplined. They know how to respect others. Apart from that, they are very peaceful children. I have seen now that in the West, the children have become so violent because of the family system. All kinds of problems that are coming. The children feel very insecure. But once they get the realization, then they are very secured in the school. They have given all the security needed. We have a regular brochure on that, what we want to do about these schools. And then we are going to have one school, big school in India, on international level, where we get children, all such children, for higher education there. Then we tell them what problems are caused by human understanding of every problem and how we can solve them. Because we have to have one world. We cannot have a world which is divided among themselves, fighting voluntarily. So this is what our idea is, to create such citizens who will be the world citizens.
Well, I think it sounds like a marvelous idea. I couldn't agree with it more. So if anyone is interested in contacting you about the school or contacting your organisation about the school, I haven't got a phone number here, but I'll get one anyway and we'll give it to you a bit later on. Have you got the brochure there? Right, here we go.
And tonight and tomorrow, they should come to my programme. Tonight and tomorrow, in exhibition building.
Right, the exhibition buildings at 7 p.m. tomorrow, and the phone number for more information is...
Tonight.
801-339. That's 801-339. You also called mother, I believe.
Yes.
Do you like that?
Of course, very much. Because self-realization is your second birth. And because I give them a second birth, that's why they call me the mother, the Holy Mother.
Well, it's very good to have you with us in Australia. Thank you for being here. Good luck with the school. And if you'd like to go along to see Sri Mataji tonight and tomorrow night, it's at the exhibition buildings at 7 p.m. And there's no charge, so it's all free.
Of course.
Thanks very much for being
here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Could your bank...